इस माध्यम के द्वारा आप उनको बताना चाहेंगे कि व्हाट आर द सिम्टम्स दैट यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट दैट द पर्सन इज गोइंग थ्रू अ ब्रेन स्ट्रोक और द पर्सन टू नो हिमसेल्फ दैट ही इज हैविंग अ स्ट्रोक.
वेल, द फोर इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स दैट एनी ले पर्सन कैन आइडेंटिफाई इज इफ देयर इज एन एसिमेट्री ऑफ द फेस, इफ द फेस डिविएट्स टू वन साइड सडनली.
ओके.
इफ देयर इज अ डिफेक्ट इन स्पीच प्रोडक्शन, इफ दे कांट प्रोड्यूस स्पीच, इफ दे जस्ट कांट टॉक, और इफ सडनली दे स्टॉप टॉकिंग.
Welcome to another episode of Fit Friday with KJ in association with Dr. Neuro. And today we have one of the most recognized, the most celebrated and the most respected neurophysician of Vadodara. Welcome sir to our show.
Thank you.
Before we go any further, mujhe ek bahut bada acha ek proverb yaad aa raha hai. Sir, salamat to pagdi hazar. Dr. Keyur Buch has been, I think, responsible to keep a lot of people healthy by their brain, I would say that. And sir has got more than 30 years of experience behind him. Sir, my first question to you is, in all these 30 years of your experience, how has the type of patients changed when you started in 1990 and today when you're seeing the patients? How what is the difference you find in patients, and how much is lifestyle disorders responsible for the patients that are coming to you?
I can think of two major changes.
Right, sir.
The incidence of stroke in younger population is being seen more and more.
Okay.
And the second one is psychosomatic disorders, depression, anxiety, stress levels going high. These two are recognized much more nowadays than it used to be 30 years back.
Okay.
And both of them have a lot to do with the lifestyle disorders.
Okay.
As far as stroke is concerned, we all know that the risk factors are mainly hypertension, diabetes, smoking, obesity, sedentary lifestyle. So all these obviously would benefit by change in lifestyle.
Right.
Regular exercise, keeping the weight under check, taking care of your blood pressure, taking care of your diet for the diabetes, quitting smoking, and being active. I mean, as we say, the new smoking is the chair.
Yes.
Sedentary lifestyle is taking up the position of smoking.
Right, right.
And it causes as many disorders as smoking used to cause. So all these changes in lifestyle are definitely going to improve the incidence of stroke. The major benefit we see is with the awareness and control of blood pressure.
Right.
The incidence of stroke has remarkably reduced, especially the brain hemorrhages. But more and more people are now having brain infarcts, which is clotting of the blood in the brain.
Okay.
And that has got to do a lot with the lifestyle measures.
Is brain stroke related to stress in a way, or it is more related to lifestyle?
I think both, but the more identifiable risk factor is lifestyle.
Okay.
Stress is more responsible for psychosomatic disorders.
Okay.
Where again lifestyle matters, because the more one exercises, the more endorphins you generate, and the less stress you have, your sense of well-being improves and the
right.
stress decreases. But stress itself can lead to worsening of diabetes, worsening of blood pressure, sedentary lifestyle leads to smoking, drugs, alcohol.
A whole lot of things.
So, a whole lot of things. So, indirectly stress increases all the risk factors of stroke. And we all know that acute bouts of stress does lead to heart attacks.
Right.
Similarly, it can lead to
brain strokes also.
In those individuals who are having the other risk factors.
Right. इस माध्यम के द्वारा आप उनको बताना चाहेंगे कि व्हाट आर द सिम्टम्स दैट यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट दैट द पर्सन इज गोइंग थ्रू अ ब्रेन स्ट्रोक और द पर्सन टू नो हिमसेल्फ दैट ही इज हैविंग अ स्ट्रोक.
वेल, द फोर इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स दैट एनी ले पर्सन कैन आइडेंटिफाई इज इफ देयर इज एन एसिमेट्री ऑफ द फेस, इफ द फेस डिविएट्स टू वन साइड सडनली.
ओके.
इफ देयर इज अ डिफेक्ट इन स्पीच प्रोडक्शन, इफ दे कांट produce speech, if they just can't talk, or if suddenly they stop talking,
right,
or their words are fumbling, that is the other thing. The third simple thing is if somebody is not feeling well, if you ask them to outstretch the hands and one of the hand is drooping down or not as strong as the other one to stay in place, that is something which will immediately tell you that there is a stroke. So you can just ask the patient to smile if it's going, the face is going to one side. Speech, obviously, you talk to them, you recognize, and outstretch the arms. And these are the three things that will immediately tell you that something is wrong and it could be a stroke.
What should be the immediate aid the person has to be given? Like in a heart attack, we have a certain protocol that, you know, first call the ambulance, then you can start the CPR. In a case of a brain stroke, what is the most important thing and the immediate thing that needs to be done?
Time is brain, so one has to immediately call an ambulance and reach a hospital where all facilities are available to thrombolyze the patient.
Okay.
Thrombolysis is administering a drug or mechanically by angiography removing the clot in the brain within a time window. Usually the time window is about 3 to 4.5 hours.
Okay.
So from the onset to the administration of the drug, it has to be within maximum 4.5 hours.
Right.
In the meantime, one has to reach the hospital, get investigated by a CT scan, be seen by the emergency doctors, and the drug has to be administered. So, usually, even if you work very fast, it goes up to 1 to 1.5 hours at the least. So, earlier the better.
So time is the essence of everything.
Yeah, it is now, the caption is time is brain.
Time is brain.
So, the more time you lose, the more brain cells you lose.
You said something disorder.
Called somatoform disorder.
Somatoform, huh.
So they are basically psychological disorders.
Right.
They present in the body.
Right.
So usually they present to us with neurological symptoms like headache, vertigo, vomiting, weakness, general feeling of ill health.
Okay.
They may present to a cardiologist with chest pain, to a gastroenterologist with abdominal pain. There is nothing wrong with the body. It's their stress which is causing them to produce symptoms in the body which mimic a disease, but the disease is not in the body.
I was reading an article which said that in India, every 6th person is depressed.
I think it's true.
So, I mean, that's what the World Health Organization has actually come and stated. We are one of the most depressed countries in the world. So, such disorders that you're saying, do you see an advent of that disorders majorly in mid-aged people or in the youth or in the elderly?
All across the spectrum.
Majority of them, you would say, would be?
Most common, it's most commonly seen in young and adult females.
Adult females?
Yeah.
Okay. So you're talking about the age from 18 to 45 something?
Exactly.
All right.
Because in our society, these women don't have the sanctity or the opportunity to express their problems.
True.
They internalize their stress and then it manifests in various problems.
Like, so in this case, sir, what is your opinion or what is your suggestion for people, especially when you're saying about women, this is majorly happening, and of course we live in a society which is basically a male dominated society, and wo bolte na ki aadmi ko agar cheek aati hai to pura ghar khada ho jata ki bhai ko cheek aa gayi. बहन ने कहीं तकलीफ होती हो, 10 दिवस की खांसी थती हो, तो ये तो स्ट्रॉन्ग है, तो कहीं ले सकते हैं साहब. दैट इज द सोसाइटी दैट वी लिव इन. सो इन दिस सिचुएशन, व्हाट वुड यू एडवाइज दीज वुमेन दैट वी आर इन एटलीस्ट इन वडोदरा टू व्हाट दे शुड डू, व्हाट दे शुड गो, वेयर दे शुड गो इन काउंसिल?
आई थिंक द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज फर्स्ट विद इन द फैमिली.
ओके.
दे शुड ओपन आउट, दे शुड बी एबल टू डिस्कस विद देयर स्पाउस, विद देयर चिल्ड्रन, with parents, and get it out.
Right.
If they internalize, it keeps worsening.
Right.
Family is the first, their first resort.
Right.
Next is having good friends whom they can communicate and express their problems and get it out. And if things are not being sorted out, then obviously see a psychiatrist.
See a psychiatrist. Yeah, if you're talking about good friends are concerned, I think people are having a few thousand people as friends on Instagram and Facebook,
yeah,
but not even four to sit and talk with.
Yes.
So that is the general thing in the society. So you've been seeing patients in and out for so many years. In doing all this, you seem to be a pretty busy guy. I mean, you are a very busy person managing this thing. How do you keep your fitness in check? And what's your fitness mantra?
Well, I think the most common excuse people have for not doing anything related to fitness is lack of time.
Right.
And the only thing that I tell them is that if I can find time, then so can you. So it's just a matter of a discipline, whether you get up on time, you spare that time for fitness. You should allocate a particular time for your fitness. If you can do that, it's not difficult.
You're the third doctor in my interviews who has said this particular thing. So what is your take on this, that how should a person stay healthy in the brain or healthy in the head? What are the cares and precautions he needs to take, and what are the mandatory things he needs to do to keep himself healthy up here?
One is obviously take care of your physical health.
Right.
If your body is fit, your mind is at ease.
Right.
Second is segregate your work and your personal life. So once you are off work, it shouldn't be bothering your head.
Right.
It doesn't matter if people feel that you are arrogant, you are not answering calls. Well, you are not on duty, you are not on duty. I'll talk about the health of doctors. It's said that on an average, a doctor lives 10 years less than an average person.
Yes, yes, yes.
That is because he takes all the stress of the world with him to his home.
Absolutely.
Which should not be the case. He is not the only doctor in the world. There are hospitals which will take care of emergencies.
True.
And it is not mandatory that you should be available 24/7.
Right.
And if you work 24 hours, you are going to make more money.
But that's it.
But that money is not everything in life. So if a rickshaw puller can be satisfied after 7 hours or 8 hours of work with whatever he has earned, then you can be satisfied, more than satisfied.
So it's more important that I think health is your only wealth that you can actually own.
True.
Today you have money, tomorrow it might go to someone else, your kids would require it, your family would require it, your business would require it. There's only one thing that you can only earn for yourself is your health, and nobody can take it away from you. Until unless you make it bad for yourself.
True.
So on this platform, sir, of our Vadodara, what will be your suggestion and your take on fitness to all the citizens of Vadodara?
My suggestion would be that do not neglect your health. Do not neglect fitness. Fitness is probably the most important thing that you can give yourself.
Right.
If you have plenty of money, but you have severe joint pains, severe muscle aches, you can't get up from your chair, you are wheelchair bound, that money is not going to give you happiness.
True.
So, look after yourself. As they say in a flight, everybody has probably experienced flight announcements once in a while. They say that in case of emergency, the oxygen mask will come down. First put on your own mask and then help the children.
Right.
So, first look after your own health, then you can help others.
True.
So, unless you look after yourself, you will not be able to look after your parents, your family, your children the way you should be doing.
Absolutely.
That is the most important thing in life.
So you heard the doctor very well, and I think this goes on well that we say that dead pools of water breed disease, and if you're not moving, you're going to breed disease too. Coming down again, thank you so much, sir, for your time, and it was a pleasure having you on this show. You keep on watching us for the next episodes coming in with much more information, with many more doctors who are going to give you a lot of insight on your health and on your fitness.